You're still watching Fifth Avenue right here, and you are on Cage and the Clay segment. We are in the life of, you know, Prophet Kenny Silweya. What a powerful song right there by, you know, Martha Natotela Bayawe. Wow, I just like the way she does her music. Awesome. Great stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, we've just been joined by the powerful mom of the house, of course. She's actually a pastor, Pastor Tiko Silweya. Yeah. Mom, how are you?
I'm okay. Thanks.
You're looking good.
Thank you.
I really wanted to have a look at you because when I look at Dad, he looks mad, you know, relaxed. You are the reason behind. What's the secret?
Amen. Not much of a secret.
Okay.
Apart from the usual things that are expected of a wife, a good wife.
Wow, great. I'm enjoying this. Okay. Man of God, so tell me, of course you spoke of your primary school level. Yeah. Run me through your tertiary education.
Yeah, well, from secondary school, there was a time I wanted to go and do some civil engineering at Copper Board University. That time it was ZIT,
okay.
Zambia Institute of Technology.
Oh yeah.
So I had to wait, and then we had to apply for some construction at Lukasha Trades.
Oh, okay.
After finishing, my turn came out. My acceptance letter.
Okay.
To go to Zambia Institute of Technology.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I started off. Meanwhile, I was also doing some kind of work, you know, working. And I don't know if you have gone down State Lodge.
Oh yeah, sure.
Yes, there's a Catholic seminary that was there.
Okay.
That one, we started it from the ground.
Okay.
So after I did part of it as it, I was in and out.
Oh yeah.
And then some of the studies, I had to do them outside.
What is your highest qualification?
A degree in civil engineering.
Wow.
But that was done partly outside.
I see. Great. Mom.
Yes, sir.
Tell me. Of all the people in the world, why did you choose to marry Prophet Kenny Silweya?
Of all the people in the world. Well, he's a good man. I went to Livingston.
Good looking man?
Not good. Not only good looking.
Ah, okay.
I looked at the heart. I had met so many before who were good looking,
mm-hmm.
and very believers or standing in the Lord. But I guess I wanted something more. I wanted somebody who would understand the way I am.
Okay.
Because I also, right from the time I was young, I knew I had a call over my life.
Okay.
So I wanted somebody that I could partner with. But basically, when I say he's a good man, I'm looking at the heart. He's very generous and very understanding, very accommodative.
Mm-hmm.
Just the few months that I had met him, I knew he's a type of a person that would want to bring out the very best of an individual.
Okay.
And so we became very good friends. Eventually, we fell in love. And
all right. Yeah. We'll get there. Man of God, tell me.
Yeah.
How did you know to say the time was ripe for you now to get married? Because this is some kind of a challenge to some of us youths to not say the time is up for you now to get married.
I think at the time that I was getting involved, I think she knows I didn't bother about marriage. I was not stranded to look for women to marry.
Why? It's because were you still handsome?
Number one, I was occupied. That time I was a youth chairman.
Yeah,
youth chairman with at Calvary Church.
Okay.
And my idea was to bring out a youth that had the kingdom mentality.
Okay.
And so I emphasized on education, working hard at home, and also just carrying themselves accordingly.
Mm-hmm.
So to me, marriage was not a problem. I think the time we met her, I was branch manager in Livingston.
Okay.
Under Indeco Estate. Mm-hmm. I was running the branch.
Mm.
Yeah, transferred from Kafue. I was maintenance. I was maintenance personnel.
Okay.
At that time, I was acting maintenance superintendent.
Okay.
Then I was transferred to Livingston on promotion.
All right.
Yeah, so the time I met her, I was managing the branch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so to me,
so what magic happened?
When she came in, I had met so many other people, but when she came in.
In as in where?
When she
into
came to Livingston.
Okay. I was from the Copper Belt.
Copper Belt with Bishop Nelly.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So when she came into Livingston, I remember the first time she came in.
The whole Livingston was on fire.
Yeah, the whole Livingston was on fire. And I gave her a chance to sing a song. And she wanted to sing. Mm-hmm. And she sang a song.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, she sang a song. And I was impressed. I said, oh, wow, this girl, you know, the voice was angelic. And I said, well, at that time, I said, God, I don't want to lose it.
All right.
Yeah, I don't want to lose it. Because people
thought time is now.
Yeah, the time is now. Because people thought I was a monk, you know.
Ah, okay.
So I stayed on.
How old were you that time around?
That time I was around 31, 32.
Oh, okay. Definitely. And, okay,
so. I had a debate. You know, ministry was pressing out on me. And I'd received an acceptance letter to go and be a lecturer.
Okay.
At TVTC to be a lecturer in one of the
institutions. Back to your love life.
Back to, yeah. Yeah, so I came back and I said, no, I think I want to settle first.
Mm-hmm.
And then when we went on, after some time, I decided to make my move. I gave an initial proposal. I told her I don't want to be your girlfriend. I haven't come in the name of prophecy.
Tell me, slow down. How long did it take after she did the song before you approached
it
her?
It took about 6 to 7 months.
Wow. You're still praying about it?
Well.
No, we were already friends then.
We were friends. Well.
Okay, now breaking the news to her.
Breaking the news to her took long.
Okay, 7 months.
Her. Yeah, I wanted to know her and whatever.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so it took about six to seven months. And
you were trying to gun the car.
Yes. Yeah, I wanted to know her better.
I see.
From there, well, I gathered information about her and vice versa. She knew where I was working. She used to come quite often at my place of work. And then I decided to make a move. And I told her, I'm not coming in the name of prophecy. I'm not coming in the name of whatever.
Hallelujah. God has taught me.
Yeah.
I was seven days on the mountain.
That would not have worked.
Yeah. Don't miss this opportunity.
That was the thing she was waiting for. So okay. She could pin me down.
Ah.
She said, if this man is going to come in the name of God told me when I was praying, God showed me. She said, I was going to break you down. I was going to pin you down.
Mm.
And I just told her, no, I want you to be the mother of my children. I want you to be my wife. Not a girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
So from there, that was the first proposal. We waited to sit it up. I had to wait.
Mm.
And she said, of course, she said yes after some 2 or 3 days.
Okay.
And then we went on. After a month or so, I followed up again. I said, well, I want to marry you. I'm serious and whatever.
Wow.
So it was serious from there on.
Okay.
And she told the father. The father was the hard man.
All right. Mom. When he approached you, he broke the news to you.
Mm-hmm.
What was your reaction? What was running in your mind?
Well, I think you know that every woman has got intuition.
Mm-hmm.
So in our friendship, I could tell that, well, I think we were getting to a place where this is not normal friendship.
It's getting
extreme. Yes. But I was not in a hurry to make him speak. I had always believed that a man should gather himself up say what it is. And as he has mentioned, I didn't want anyone to come in the name of Jesus, in the name of prophecy. I didn't want.
But you could read his moves.
I could read them to a certain extent. Mm-hmm. But because of his personality and what what I had gathered around in Livingston, I was not sure whether he would literally or comfortably just propose like that. Why? Because you know how it is when somebody is highly looked up to and the like. So, as I could see, we were friends, but I was relatively new in Livingston. So I was thinking, is this the way he really treats everyone around and all? But I could see the friendship was quite special.
Mm.
And but anyway, when he did propose, I did not hesitate, because the thing I was trying to pin him down on was if he were going to come in the name of God.
Mm.
I was going to say no, even if I had liked him.
Okay, tell me, before he approached you, did you develop the liking for him?
Yes, I did.
Or you anticipated that if at all he were to make a move, then...
By then, I had already developed a love, actually, for him.
Ah, wow.
Not just a mere liking.
Okay.
Yeah, and that's why I started from the angle of intuition. Mm-hmm. You are able to tell that, okay, I mean, that's why sometimes a lady would say from afar, "Sini mufu now you." Mm-hmm. Why? Because you can tell. I will not click. But for him, it was actually, we became fond of each other. We could not, a day would not pass without even calling.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so somehow the friendship grew stronger, and so I knew I would expect this kind of question popping up one day or the other. So I when he said that, I didn't hesitate. I didn't tell him, no, I'm going to pray about it or what. Of course, I did tell him my fears. And let me tell you what my fear was that time. I told him I didn't want to get married to a man of God. So he laughed. I remember he really burst into laughter.
You tell me why not man of God?
Oh, my God. It's a long story. But okay. Basically, the impression of pastoral work that time was not very comfortable.
Okay, I get it.
Not because I didn't want to go through suffering or whatever, but I had my own reservations.
Okay,
and I know that God is faithful. I know God is true. I know sometimes you go through a certain space of, but the picture I had was not good enough only for a few that I could emulate.
Oh, yeah,
and I was not sure whether that would come to me.
Okay, great. Man of God, tell me, how did you break the news to mom?
Well, I gathered myself. It was not easy. I gathered myself and together. And then finally, I escorted her. She was staying very, very far from where I was working.
Mm-hmm.
And on this particular maternal day, I decided to release myself. You know, there are those issues where say, when you reach that corner, I'll tell her.
You know, today, I'll need to break the news. You read there, you just go quiet.
Then you just go mute.
Yes, because, maybe tomorrow.
Maybe tomorrow. But this time around, I gathered myself. I said, Lord, I'm so sure.
Mm-hmm.
And of course.
Who were you comfortable to break the news to, mom or dad?
At that particular time, my mother was my mother was very, very far.
Okay.
Because
so it was
staying,
dad.
Both of them were very far.
Both of them were very, very far.
You were keeping up with who?
I was staying
because
on my
he was
own.
Manager.
Oh, okay. So you it was a core thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, just walking. I mean, I escorted her.
Okay.
Broke the news.
I mean, to your parents.
No, to your parents.
Or to my parents. Yeah. Okay. In those days, we used to have cell phones. It was letter writing.
So you did jot down.
The I did the jotting down.
But you did tell
my
your
nearest,
elder
my nearest
sister.
Person was my elder sister.
Okay.
I took her to Kabwe.
Wow.
Yeah, because that time she was managed, the husband was a manager with
Kabwe Kamkuba.
Yeah, Kabwe. Yes. We were staying in that region. So I took her to Kabwe. And then we met her during that period of time. She was doing prayer and fasting
For
40 days.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so.
So she lost a bit of weight?
Yeah, she did. 40 days.
Okay.
So I went to introduce her to her. And then she didn't as that my sister was a woman of discernment.
Mm.
Ah, she was the woman of time.
Wow.
She just said, this is your wife. This is your wife.
Wow.
And she counseled us. And
you tell me, was she the first person that you presented to your sister as your wife to become?
Well, you know, these, I don't know what you call relationships.
Okay.
Where you're passing through, but you're not convinced and convicted.
Yeah.
There was one person, one or two, that were closer to me. But my sister was a prayerful woman.
Oh, yeah.
And eventually things just went wrong. I'm not a person who likes disappointing somebody.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
yeah, but I don't know. I can't explain it. And it was not me, of course. It was just a situation.
Oh, yeah.
And I was
sometimes
not disappointed.
It could be a plan of God. You
yeah,
never
the
know.
Plan of God. Exactly. But to cut a story short, we went our separate ways.
Okay.
She didn't ditch me. I didn't ditch her.
Mm-hmm.
But there was some confusion.
Oh, yeah, sure.
My sister just came and said, no. Here, I think. But I thank
this
God that
not
at least it had to be that way because eventually the lady passed on.
Okay.
She was coming from a pastoral home and whatever.
Okay.
Yeah, but when I stayed for some time without anybody.
Okay, now the issue of Tumbale. How did you take the place?
I had to... My elder sister apparently passed on. Yeah, the one who...
Oh, the same who consented.
Same, yeah,
okay.
Yeah, passed on. I think she couldn't come out of the prayer and fasting.
Oh,
I think didn't treat her well.
Mm-hmm.
But I took my older brother from from Kitwe.
Okay.
Then went to Ndola with my uncle, Mr. Silweya, yeah. So we went to visit the parents because I think her fear was to go and meet with the father. So she had broken the news to the father. The father was the hard man.
Okay.
And why she was saying, I don't want to get married to a man of God, she always says, God tricked me because in the first place, I was a manager at that time. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So
you went as a manager, not as a man of God. You tricked your in-laws man of God. Okay.
Yeah. So we had driven over there and then we went to see them. It was not easy.
Mm-hmm.
The father was a tough man. And she didn't know how to break the news. But anyway, she had to break the news. And what does it do? What about the visit, the tribe and everything? And for some reason, the father didn't hesitate.
Ah!
We went to meet with them.
Shockingly.
Wow.
Shockingly.
The power of prayer.
And, everything was done. They charged us, and in those days it was fair, but it was still high.
All right, mom, tell me.
Yes.
He was a leader, a well-known non-leader, a well-to-do man as well, both in the secular and, of course, a church. Then he happens to love you alone. Tell me, did you receive some criticism or some attack from the ladies
I
around?
I actually do an encyclopedia on that.
Okay.
Yeah, I did go through some tough time, and living from being a small city, I went through, well, I guess it's, I don't know, I didn't expect it anyway, but I've realized that that's the way life is. Sometimes when, maybe some people thought he would marry their children, or even them as in young ladies, and it's normal because he had been with them for a longer time. But I did go through a bit of this and that, which felt a bit weird because it was my first experience. I had never gone through that because of a man.
Okay.
So for me, I felt like, really? Is this the only man around? At one time, I think you marry. Marry them.
You go on.
Yeah, because I had funny encounters, you know. But all the same, being a believer, being grounded in the Lord, helps one to settle down. Somehow, in all that frustration, I still had somebody to talk to other than him.
Oh, okay.
And that is God. So
all right.
Yeah.
Tell me.
That was my consolation.
The wedding arrangement. Mm-hmm. What happened? How did you go about it?
It's you.
Man of God.
Well, it was tough. We had to do one or two things, put on.
How long did it take before you broke the news to your in-laws and then the process to getting married officially?
To my in-laws. The in-laws?
Yes.
It didn't take long.
Mm-hmm.
It took some months.
Okay.
Because I was busy preparing, and I was a single man, so I accommodation wise, the Lord had given me proper accommodation. It wasn't so much of a problem.
Okay.
But I think within some months.
I see.
Yeah.
So how long have you been together now?
20 years.
20 years, and how many children do you have?
We'll be clocking our 21st this year.
Ah, okay. Congrats.
We are
veterans.
Yeah.
High five.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Ah. All right. So how many children do you have together?
We have 4 children. 2 boys, 2 girls. But we have adopted another one.
My sister's
kid. Yeah, my
sister's
okay. kid. Yeah.
Okay, okay, okay. All right. So tell me, you planned to have 4 or what?
She wanted 3. I wanted 4. Okay. I wanted equal numbers.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So the set is complete. You have 2 girls, two boys.
Yeah. Two boys. Yeah.
Okay. The firstborn is?
Tawanga is 19. Will be turning
a boy?
20 this year. Yeah, a boy.
Okay.
Yeah,
will be turning
20 this year.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So.
Then we'll Tendai.
Tendai Ken. The girls are Kens.
Ah. Okay.
Yeah. So Tendai Ken. Yeah,
okay.
She's at Kapiri Tech.
Okay.
She's doing grade 10.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she'll be turning 15 this year. Yeah, 15 this year.
All right.
She's 14.
You have to count through now.
She's 14.
Yeah.
Then we have a third one, a girl, Taiza Ken. She's in grade 5 now.
Yeah.
Yeah, grade 5.
All right. Yeah. Mom.
Yes, sir.
We know the man of God. He's not an angel. He's not a saint.
Uh-huh.
He's just a human being like
a
you
human
and me.
Being. A full human of.
Exactly. You know, full of, you know, shortcomings.
Yes,
so
yes.
Tell me, when you look at him, what would you want him to improve on?
Well, caught unawares.
Exactly.
That I will not lie.
Mm.
Well, maybe just his length of time in ministry. And I wish I could adjust that.
How?
Yeah,
yeah, because he's a person that would preach like 1 hour, 30 minutes. And he can go for 5 to 6 hours
all right.
in ministry,
okay,
pray for one-on-one.
Okay, so
that's the only thing.
I don't want you to say it as a member of the church, but as a wife.
Yes, I'm talking as a wife.
No. Something to do probably with him being your husband, not as a pastor.
Oh, okay. That's what I'm saying. I need to think.
Oh, yeah, think, please.
I need to think.
You have a minute. You have 2 seconds to think.
Maybe he's being too quiet. There are times when he's too quiet, and I'm very... very sociable.
Okay.
So there are times when he's a normally very quiet person. He's very loud at the pulpit.
Okay.
But even when he's at home, there are times when he's very quiet. And there are times when I would want him to talk. I think coming from that side, as a wife, yeah, that's the only thing.
All right. You've been together for 20 years now. You're turning 21.
Yeah.
Has there been a time where you thought probably the man of God is cheating on me.
No, not really. And I'm saying really because, of course, that would come across your mind when somebody brings in something.
Oh, yeah.
But in my own deepest heart of hearts, I was very doubtful.
Okay.
And I'm saying this because it's something that when you know somebody, and at the time I was meeting him, he was not a young boy.
Mm.
I met him when he was already around 30.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So we're talking about somebody who had a good testimony in that area. So even when that would cross my mind because somebody said something, I was very doubtful and I sat back. And
so in other words, so people could come to you to tell you stories about him?
I would not say people would. It was not a habitual thing. It happened once.
Okay.
But that I turned down because in my heart I felt, no, that's impossible.
But from your own assessment,
nothing? From my own assessment because, no, we move a lot together.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so
you covered, you protected.
the few times that he's moved alone, he moved with a team of guys.
Ah, okay.
And that's maybe twice in ministry. Generally, we do a lot of things together. So my trust for him, I think, is too much. The 1% I leave for God.
Ah, okay. Why not give him 99%?
Yeah, that's then you get 1%. 99, so the 1%, that's what I'm saying, it's too much. It goes up to 99. I leave 1%. Even for medical personnel, they leave 1%.
I'm learning this. All right, man of God, what song are we going to listen to?
We're going to listen to... Tamlayo Wufi by Agape.
We'll be right back.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you for watching this program. If you've been blessed by the ministration of the Faith Avenue family, subscribe by clicking the red button. It's not difficult to subscribe. Thank you for subscribing.